options and switch outs. But with these Splatermane, it works a lot better. But here we go. The leads are here once again in this final.
Yeah, exactly. It's the grand finals here in Gdansk. It is Oliver Eskelin against Simone Sanvito. It is Golden Go Rillaboom against Tornadus and Rillaboom.
Okay, so double Rillaboom lead, double fake out for these trainers as well. So you can see Simone straight away locking in here. He's had plenty of time to think about this lead right now. And it's going to be the immediate terror coming out here in this final.
Yeah, Golden Go in such a strong spot. Neither Tornadus nor that Rillaboom wants to take a Bleakwind Storm. Now, one question, of course, is with that Terrestrialization to steal right away, fake out is an option because, of course, now that Goldengo is not a ghost type anymore, but it looks like Simone has different plans. Now he would like to have a steel resistance and is going to terrestrialize his Tornadus.
Okay, and interesting to note that the Goldengo act does outspeed the Tornadus here as well, which is really interesting. Fake out does go into Simone's Tornadus, so it is not going to be moving this turn because it's not the covert cloak. Rillaboom taking a little bit from the rocky helmet, but here comes the make it rain steel terror boost. Choice Specs boosted, hitting both opponents. Rillaboom is on fire. Wow. One HP here with a critical hit to boot as well, as Tornadus takes over half of its health going down. So an excellent defensive terror from Simone's end here, as U-turn goes into the Rillaboom on Oliver's end to switch out and reset that board position.
Whew, yeah, Simone will need to take a deep breath now after that critical hit. Well, he knows exactly what he wants. He wants that Xian Pao to be on the field. So with that lead, Oliver is forcing the terrestrialization to steal because, yeah, the fake out and make it rain combination would have knocked out that Tornadus. And yeah, we saw what Simone had in the back. There wasn't particular any switch into make it rain. Now with that terrestrialization though, Sacred Sword, a very, very powerful option for Simone to deal with that Goldengo.
Yeah, really powerful. And I think the traditional focus dash jump probably won't be enough, but a life orb one may well be. We'll have to see here, but maybe with the intimidate coming in, it may well not be at the moment, but the make it rain is still very going to be oppressive here. Sacred Sword, yeah, obviously does so much damage, to be honest. So Arcanine coming in right at the right time.
No tailwind.
The Make It Rain just outspeeds the Tornadus yet again. Let's see if it's enough this time. It's not, but Xian Pao goes straight down.
Yeah, barely not enough to knock out that Tornadus with that next Make It Rain, possibly also after that grassy terrain recovery that the Tornadus could enjoy with its newfound steel type. Bleak Windstorm coming out, getting that knockout on Goldengo.
Yeah, it makes sense. I suppose if you've got the minus one on the special attack on Oliver's end, then you know, even if it did about half last time with the grassy terrain recovery on the Tornadus, that you're probably going to survive another one too. And now Simone's able to go for his tailwind a little bit later in the game to really make the most of it. And he looks like he saved that Fluttermane for last here, and looks like just at the right time as well, as the Golden Goat has already gone down here. Yeah. As Tornadus actually comes in for Oliver.
Yeah, two very low HP Pokemon on Simone's side, and that Arcanine over on Oliver's side, of course, has access to extreme speed. And yeah, the question is now, with Xian Pao out of the picture for Simone, what can he really do to stop that Arcanine?
Yeah, it's a great question. Like, it was kind of his main answer, and he didn't bring the Urshifu either, which was an issue versus Eric Reyes in the top four as well, when he didn't bring it into that game too. So, like, this Arcanine is looking really strong right now, and the Fluttermane, we've seen, has a decent amount of bulk. It can live a few attacks from Arcanines, especially when they're at minus one if they're banded, and this Arcanine is not banded, so it's kind of, you're in the same sort of position where you know you could probably take a Flare Blitz here.
Yeah.
But this Fluttermane is going to be naturally faster, and there's both Tornadus at either end here. The question is, does Simone maybe go for a Taunt here to kind of, like, prevents the Tornadus from getting its own tailwind, but no, he's going straight for his own right now.
Yeah, straight for the tailwind, but of course Oliver also has a Tornadus, so could match that tailwind if needed. Shadow Ball is coming out on the Arcanine, not quite enough, and with that Citrus Berry, oh, but there is a special defense drop. Let's see if that's going to matter. With that Citrus Berry, of course, Arcanine is able to recover a little bit of health, and if that is a Flare Blitz aimed at that Fluttermane, that would do a ton of damage.
Yeah, ton of damage, but the Fluttermane does hold on there, showing off its bulk in front of this huge Arcanine.
Bleakwind Storm hits.
Oh, it's a double KO.
Knockout!
Oh my goodness, Oliver is cooking today. Tornadus goes completely down here. It has set up the Tailwind, but it may be a little too late, as Rillaboom is the last Pokemon to come in here for Simone.
Yeah, and Rillaboom is not a great Pokemon into Tornadus, and also, of course, that Arcanine now recovering a little bit more health, and Rillaboom at 1 HP. Yeah. I don't see how that could take the game around for Simone.
No, it's back to the drawing board potentially for Simone at the moment here, as Oliver's positioned his Arcanine very nicely here. E-Speed to just finish off that game one.
And Oliver Eskelin is only one more game away from becoming a regional champion here in Gdansk. What a masterful play with that Golden Go. And the question now, of course, is what can Simone even do to stop that Golden Go?
It's a great question here. Like, the Terra Steel was, like, perfectly called there by Simone. He knew exactly what was coming out that turn, but it still put him in a position where it eventually went down to all of the onslaught that Oliver had. And even though it set up the Tailwind, it was just a little bit too late because of the immediate offense that Golden Go does provide here. So, yeah, Simone needs to think a little bit more about what he wants to kind of bring into this matchup, really. And that Arcanine was absolutely huge in being able to dish out as much damage as it could to the, like, Fluttermane. And Simone didn't bring his own Arcanine for Intimidate, nor the Urshifu. So, the two main answers to Oliver's Arcanine. So, I think we're going to see at least one of those in this game.
Yeah, I agree. That's, I think, always something that is a little bit annoying for Simone now sitting down there. He had a little bit of time to prepare the matchup. He already played against Oliver's team. And maybe he came up with these four being, in his opinion, the optimal choice. But now this gets refuted pretty much instantly by Oliver, saying that, okay, well, with this new Golden Go and Rillaboom idea, you don't have any switch-ins into the Make It Rain, and even with that terrestrialization on Tornadus, it wasn't quite enough. So I wonder, I agree with you there. I think Urshifu or Arcanine, maybe both of them, might probably make it to the second game here for Simone.
Yeah, and honestly, as a lead as well, both of those, then, like, and if Oliver leaves the same, he can only fake out one of them, and then the other can at least threaten maybe a Terra-boosted Surging Strikes or even a close combat if he, like, predicts the Terra Steel on the Golden Go as well. And the Arcanine can threaten the Flare Blitz either way, as the Terra Steel is going to make it weak to fire either way too. So maybe that could be a complete switch up there. But obviously, Oliver may have a second plan up his sleeve.
Yes, absolutely. Yeah. Oliver, of course, also knows that the kind of caliber of a player that Simone is, and that Simone easily can adapt to something that Oliver has shown him in game one. So yeah, this might be one of those situations where Oliver might not go back to that same game plan, even though it worked so well for him in game one.
Yeah, like, he's definitely one game ahead here. And when you're in that kind of position, you must be thinking, like, right, I've one game ahead. I can still lose this game and still kind of have another game to kind of back on with. So it does put Oliver in an advantage here, because he might feel a little bit more confident to play a little bit more risky or go for or try and call Simone's lead coming in here.
Yeah, I think sometimes that can also be a little bit dangerous, because then sometimes you might want to, you play it, like, too careless. Looks like that is not what Oliver has in mind right now, as he goes for the exact same lead again. Simone, though, switching things up with the Tornadus and Jian Pao.
Yeah, so this is really nice here too, obviously, because with the Golden Go only having attacking move, Sucker Punch could do a lot of damage into this Golden Go unless it goes for another Terra. And if it does commit to the Terra this time, it can also go for a Sacred Sword. So I really like a Protect play on this Jian Pao. But Arcanine's coming in first just to keep that Golden Go a little bit safer.
Yeah, we saw in the previous game with that Intimidate, Jian Pao not able to knock out that terrestrialized Golden Go anymore, and we will see a terrestrialization right away coming out from that Golden Go once again. So Oliver preventively wants to make sure that there is no way Golden Go gets knocked out this turn, even when he doesn't go for that fake out.
So it's the Terra Steel once again, and it looks like the Terra Steel again for Simone. So double axe heads for these Pokemon in games one and two on turn one for both games as well. So it looks like it's going to be playing out a little bit more similarly here, but maybe with a couple of different choices on the for the pairings here. Yep, Jian Pao going for the Protect. Really good to scout out what this choice specs Golden Go is going to lock into here. But first, going to be that Make It Rain into this Tornadus. We saw it do about 50% last time, so it's probably going to do the same again.
Yeah, and Simone will like to see that, because of course this is the turn that he anticipated. Maybe not the switch out into Arcanine, but definitely that Make It Rain. And with this Bleakwind Storm, we saw in the previous game how the combination of Sacred Sword and Bleakwind Storm was able to knock out the Golden Go. So now the question, of course, is even with that grassy terrain turns, was there any sort of damage rolls maybe? If that Sacred Sword is enough to get the knockout on the Golden Go, then that is what Simone wants to do.
Yeah, like, it did, honestly did so much damage there, didn't it? So, like, with the grassy terrain recovery as well, it might be very, very close right now. Depends if Simone, like, feels like he wants to go for it in this turn. Oliver, though, though, has his very effective Arcanine here, so even if the Chainpower gets that move off, it could even trade for it with a Flare Blitz this time. But Urshifu's coming instead. Sacred Sword, is it enough? No, the Golgo does hang on here, so it's going to be able to get that off another huge make it
That's
rain.
Absolutely huge, as this will knock out the Chainpower, no problem, and do a lot of damage also to that Urshifu. And then Arcanine on Oliver's side will have the chance to do even more damage to that Urshifu.
Yeah, and if this is a Flare Blitz coming out, it's going to be a huge ton of damage. It may even then put the Urshifu into an extreme speed KO range here, meaning Simonica won't even be able to get off an Aqua Jet in the following turn. But look at that damage. It might be enough, though, to remove it from an extreme speed range, though.
Yeah, especially after that grassy terrain, that could be enough. But yeah, Urshifu, of course, you don't want to take so much damage when entering the field. And once again, another great turn there from Oliver. His Goldingo taking that combination with that little bit of help from that grassy terrain. So yeah, really nicely positioning there, that Goldingo.
Yeah, now it's still in here, though, still with that Terra Steel, and even though it's at minus two, it's probably still threatening a ton of damage. But Protosynthesis is going to activate, boosting the special attack of this Fluttermane. Yeah. We've seen it do about 60% to the Arcanine with a Shadow Ball, so it may not be enough. But with the combination of an Aqua Jet, it just may well be, as the Arcanine on Oliver's end cannot protect, as we've seen, even though it can switch up its moves. So on Oliver's end here, he's got two Pokemon that can't protect, but it depends on whether he wants to maybe save one for one Pokemon in the back. But honestly, Rillaboom's looking really strong for Oliver in the back because of the grassy glide into either of these targets.
Yeah, I think the play from Simone here is pretty much telegraphed. You have that Fluttermane that is faster than both of your opponent's Pokemon. You can finally get that knockout on the Goldingo, as there's no Tailwind, no Protect on Oliver's side. And then, of course, that Urshifu is there to take on that Arcanine. But of course, Oliver knows that as well, and that Rillaboom, as you said, in such a good position, might also be a nice switch in here. But no, instead, it's going to be that Tornadus.
Tornadus is coming in here, like catching that Aqua Jet really nicely with a little bit of Rocky Helmet Chip that may put it in range of a Make It Rain coming out, and it's just a Dazzling Gleam, which is going to be enough for the Goldingo and putting the Tornadus very low.
Absolutely, and now with that Goldingo out of the way, Oliver has the chance to bring in one more Pokemon. It's probably going to be actually both the Rillaboom and the Arcanine carry priority moves that could knock out that Urshifu. Oliver, though, deciding to bring out the Rillaboom, threatening with the Grassy Glide and also threatening that Fluttermane potentially with a Tailwind and Woodhammer play.
Yeah, and we can see Simone there kind of checking up very nicely for us, the grassy terrain turns being two more left, which is going to be very big because Rillaboom is going to definitely be relying on those grass-type attacks. Fluttermane is going to be able to survive some sort of grassy glide, but like with no Intimidate in the back for Simone, this Rillaboom's probably looking quite the threat.
Yeah, Simone's play going for the Protect and Switch is relatively defensive. He really needs to make it through this turn, though. If Oliver correctly expected the switch and not the Tornadus, this game might be over pretty soon.
So it's a Tailwind. Is it a high horsepower from this Rillaboom? We'll have to see. It is the Woodhammer, though, into the Fluttermane. So good call by Simone there to defensively get in his Tornadus here, which is the one with the taunt, so a Tailwind will be able to come up from his end here.
Yeah, nice play there, I would say, by Simone now getting that Tornadus in, and he has the option to match the Tailwind if he wanted to. It's gonna be really tough because, of course, that Rillaboom, you could go for like a Tailwind and Moonblast, but Rillaboom would be able to take that and then strike back with a strong Woodhammer, probably knocking out the Fluttermane. So now it's also a little bit about how much recoil would that do? And can you then maybe knock out the Rillaboom with that recoil? Because, of course, Urshifu that Simone has in the back is very much favored against that Arcanine.
It's going to be the Tailwind and that Dazzling Gleam that's coming out now. And that's enough for the Tornado, so no more Bleakwind Storms coming out here. Oliver has single target attacks on his Rillaboom, so something is probably going to be going down here. It's going to be that Woodhammer nicely targeting into that Fluttermane, doing a huge ton, and that's a one-hit KO there.
One-hit KO indeed. And now let's see a little bit of recoil, of course, on that Rillaboom, but still sitting there kind of healthy, of course. That grassy terrain, though, I think that's the last round. Yep, there it goes. No more boosts, of course, to the grass-type attacks, but more notably also no more priority grassy glide.
So yeah, Arcanine's going to come in for Oliver here, but it still does have extreme speed. So this Urshifu may well be in range for that extreme speed. It's going to depend on the training. Obviously, Marcus, I think it's so close as to whether it can go down to this or not. The Tornadus is in. It's got that Bleakwind Storm. We know it's a very bulky Tornadus as well. So with the Assault Vest on the Rillaboom, it may even still live this Bleakwind Storm. We'll have to see how much damage this does. Honestly, depends on the individual training of these Pokemon.
Simone has to play this as if his Urshifu can take on that extreme speed, but we're seeing here a Raynet and an Aqua Jet, and that is going to be enough for the knockout.
No E-Speed!
Arcanine just goes down in one hit, and what can the Rillaboom do about this?
Woodhammer into the Urshifu this time, though. It's going to be enough to KO this Urshifu. But with the Rain Dance up now, Bleakwind Storms can no longer miss. And this Tornadus is probably going to be going first. And now it's going to be single target into this Rillaboom. Simone may have just turned this around.
He may very... I'm at a loss of words. Yeah, Bleakwind Storm comes out. It takes out the Rillaboom. It looked as if Oliver was so close of taking home that game. But then with that Rain Dance and Aqua Jet, one hit knock out on that Arcanine Hisui. Honestly, Simone's back in the series.
Yeah, he's completely back in it there. Excellent play there, honestly, by Simone to really pull it back and putting us into a game three for the grand finals of the Gdansk Regional Championship. So going into this game three, we've seen Oliver go for the same lead both times, Marcus. So thinking into the third game, now that it hasn't really worked out for him as it played out, do you think he's going to go for it again?
Yeah, well, it looked so strong in the first game, and also it looked like in the second game for the longest time, it looked like as if his Golden Go once again would do too much damage for his opponent to handle. But yeah, that adaption of Simone leading off of the Qian Pao proved to be so strong, even with that survival on the Golden Go, taking that Sacred Sword and Bleakwind Storm combination. So yeah, I think Simone might very well go back to exactly that strategy.
Yeah, like it seemed to work excellently well there. The Qian Pao threatening so much damage, and like even though it wasn't getting the KOs on that Golden Go, yeah, it put it in range of so many of Simone's attacks, like the spread Bleakwind Storm, the Aqua Jets that he seems to really rely on there too. So the Tornadus pulling through yet again here, which makes a lot of sense on both of these players' ends as well, putting a lot of like impetus on like how important it is to have speed control on your side of the field exactly when you want it.
Yeah, now the question of course could be, after Oliver has used the same strategy twice in a row, I feel like the lead of Simone in the second game wasn't like a hard counter or anything, because there was still the option was still there to go for like the fake out and make it rain, which is kind of tough for Simone to deal with still. Maybe Simone wants to try and read that Rillaboom Golden Go lead even harder to try to go for maybe, I don't even know what would be a better choice. Maybe leading off with that Urshifu, but then of course you are threatened by that Rillaboom. Maybe that Qian Pao is actually his best bet.
Okay, so it is actually a switch up here on Oliver's end, and the Urshifu Torn as well on Simone's end. So a switch up a piece here, but the Tornadus are finally on the field at the same time at the start of this game here. So like Simone does have that Taunt option if it is the faster Tornadus, but I think we're still yet to find out whether that is the case. But I really like the Urshifu switch up here too, because you can finally lead a Pokemon that is resisting these Make It Rains.
Yeah, finally, but at the same time, Make It Rain, of course, with the Terrestrialization boost that it looks like Oliver once again will be going for. This is the third turn one Terra Steel on his Golden Go. That would still deal a lot of damage even into that resisted Urshifu. So now it looks like Simone wants to try and go for a Protect on the first turn, just so that Golden Go will drop its own special attack in the process of the first attack it's going for. And with that Terra Steel that we've seen a couple of times now from Simone as well, his Tornadus will now resist anything that Golden Go or the Tornadus can throw at it.
So it's going to be the Tech from the Urshifu as you've choreographed there, Marcus. Tailwind is going to be the option for Oliver here, so it definitely pulls that out the bag here. So Golden Go should be going next. And is there going to be that Make It Rain? We know how much damage this does. So we know the Tornadus is going for that Bleakwind Storm again to potentially try and put that Golden Go in range of a Sacred Sword. The big difference being now, the Rillaboom has not been led as in previous games. So Golden Go is no longer going to have the grassy terrain recovery that it got last time, and so may actually now be in Sacred Sword range from a potential Qian Pao that could be in the back.
Absolutely. That's just such a small detail, but those 11 HP, they made all the difference in that previous game. So now the question is, can Simone's Tornadus take another one of those Make It Rains after it's already taken one and Golden Go has dropped its special attack stat? Rillaboom will be joining the battle with the Assault Vest, should be able to take this relatively well, but Make It Rain, yeah, is the Tornadus going down? Oh, 2
not
HP!
Quite. Oh, that's very close. Okay, so cutting it fine there.
But
this time,
there's
this game
a follow-up.
Oh, the follow-up from Bleakwind Storm is enough to KO this Tornadus. Double connections all around, and Rillaboom is now on a slither of health right now for Simone, but he is able to bring in something completely fresh from the back.
But still, it was very important that that Tornadus actually took that attack, because if it went down, then the Bleakwind Storm would have been a single target. Therefore, with this increased power, probably would have been able to knock out that Rillaboom Rillaboom. So now, thanks to those 2 HP, Simone still has 3 Pokemon available, and he will bring in his Urshifu now to try to crawl his way back into this game.
Yeah, so the Urshifu is now here. Lots of priority apiece here, so it really does help unpay dividends when you're like stuck in a position where the speed control is maybe not so much in your favor here. So Simone's definitely got a lot of options, and especially having an Urshifu that can survive and make it rain, it's going to make a big difference.
Yeah, there's the fake out going into the Tornadus. Now this Rocky Helmet will almost knock out that Rillaboom, but that Make It Rain certainly will. Rillaboom going down, Urshifu taking the hit relatively well, and now this Urshifu has a choice to make. Do you want to knock out that Tornadus, or do you want to knock out that Goldingo finally?
Okay, we'll have to see. Yeah, the Tornadus is going for the flinch there. Simone's identifying the Goldingo as the threat, as I think I would have rightly done too, looking at how much damage it's been doing.
Yeah.
That's 2 hits. It looks like a third might be enough here, and yes, it is. Goldingo's finally going down. Terra Steel, Axe Heads are all off the field this time. But Simone is finally down to his last 2, and that's only the first KO he's gotten onto Oliver's end.
Yeah, it looks like just barely that Searching Strikes, those Searching Strikes were enough to knock out that Goldingo with some of the chip damage that we saw earlier. So important and well calculated there by Simone. And that last Pokemon on his side is going to be that Chen Pao. Now Oliver thinking about what to bring in here. Looks like it's going to be that Arcanine, and that is going to be a great choice here with the Intimidate. However, of course, against that Urshifu, that's the one Pokemon that Arcanine doesn't like to face.
No, it really doesn't. As we saw, Rain Dust, but Aqua Jet was just more than enough to get that Arcanine earlier. We're obviously not in the same position right now, but Sword of Ruin is now on the field, and that's going to make a big difference for some of the calculations for all of these physical attackers that are on the field. So looking at this set at the moment now, this Arcanine has a lot of targets it can potentially go for, and an extreme speed, for instance, into the Urshifu is going to be boosted by the Sword of Ruin because of Simone's own Chien Pao. So that's going to do a heap ton of damage, and combined with the Bleak Storm, that may be enough to kind of pick it up here.
Yeah, Simone also, of course, having those priority moves available with the Sucker Punch and the Aqua Jet. Sucker Punch will land on the Tornadus. Not enough to get the knockout there.
Is there an Aqua Jet following up to try and KO this as well? We'll have to see. Life Orb and that Rocky Helmet chip, that's a lot of big, but it's the Aqua Jet into the Arcanine. But yes, it's enough instead, despite the Intimidate as well. That's a massive KO
but
there.
But now, of course, the Bleak Wind Storm. Will it connect? It does connect, and it will knock out Urshifu. Chien Pao's the last Pokemon remaining for Simone.
And a speed drop on the Chien Pao as well here. So going to the next turn, the Chien Pao may not even outspeed this Tornadus in this endgame either. But the thing is, the Tailwind has now run out as well. The Bleak Wind Storm, though, is not 100% accurate.
And Rillaboom's
coming in, though, which is a very bulky Pokemon here. Chien Pao, it should be going on the Protect for this turn here to scout out for that Fake Out, but it's coming down to the wire, Marcus.
Absolutely. Rillaboom, of course, having access to that priority Grassy Glide, that would be one option to knock out that Chien Pao. So now Simone has to go for the Protect, getting a little bit of recovery from the grassy terrain, potentially stalling out that move's effect. And then it comes down to how many more turns of Tailwind does Oliver have, because that Tornadus isn't going anywhere, of course.
Yeah, no, it's not at all. Fake Out is going in there, and it's going to get away with a potential Bleak Wind Storm here as well, or even a Tailwind. And because of the speed drop in this Chien Pao, this Rillaboom should be able to outspeed and may not even need the Grassy Glide here.
Yep. Yeah, very well observed. Only one turn left of Grassy Glide.
Yep, it's going to have to be Sucker Punch to see if it KOs, but it's not enough. Grassy Glide has done it into Simone San Vito. He takes the KO. Oliver finally gets his regional win. Huge congratulations to Oliver Eskelin of Finland there, beating the previous regional championship, preventing him from getting that back-to-back win. He must be feeling over the moon from there.